Yesterday we had begun with the play, the Browning version. Yes. And what is it about? The Browning version, it is about student-teacher relationship. It is about students discussing teachers. It is about understanding the subjects, right? Method of teaching. And here in this chapter, there are two characters. One is Frank and one is Taplow. Frank is the science teacher. He is a young teacher and he is quite popular among the students. Taplow is a student. It is the last day of the term. The students are going to get their grades or their marks the next day. But Taplow is here on the last day doing extra work because he had missed a class. So to compensate for that, he is working on the last day. He might be a good student, but as always, what is our opinion about people who are not, you know, like who do their work on the last moment or who have a problem there? So we think that these people are not regular, they're not interested in their study. So we have that kind of an impression about them, right? This is what Frank thinks about Taplow. Now, Taplow is doing extra work for his classical literature teacher. Who is he? He is Mr. Crocker Harris. And Mr. Crocker Harris is said to be a very strict teacher. He is very particular about rules and regulations. He does not announce the results. He does not tell the marks beforehand. They're only announced at the last day of the term. So if a teacher is doing all these things, then what is wrong about it? That is very right. That means he's very dutiful. He's very particular, right? But students and teachers, you know, they have a problem because nowadays we like people who are a little lenient, who have a little bit of fun, who are there having a smiling face. They might crack jokes and they might be a little, you know, like friendly with the students. But Mr. Crocker Harris is not that kind of a person. He's leaving the school. It's his last day. But even to the last day, he is very concerned. He is very particular about what? His rules and regulations. Okay, right? So some people like him, some people don't. Now, who are there? The students are not happy because he's very strict. He's very particular about his work. And the teachers wonder that what is it about him that makes him such a strict teacher? What is it that make people, you know, that students afraid of him? So even though you will realize in this play, there is not a single dialogue of Mr. Crocker Harris, but he is present in the play. We learn about his character. We learn about him as a teacher through the dialogues, through the conversation between Frank and Taplow. So if people are there discussing someone, that means, yes, that person is there quite important. That people has the interest of others, right? So this teacher has created the interest and everybody wants to know what is so strict. Okay, so let's continue with our reading. So now we have come to the part where Taplow was imitating his teacher, which is not a good thing to do. Of course, yeah, we do but in the presence of another teacher, you're talking about someone else, right? So when we do discuss teachers or with students, I think so we should understand to what extent, okay? Because we should not get carried away. We should not get too personal. We should not get too casual also in our discussion. Now here, Taplow was imitating the teacher, and he said that Mr. Crocker Harris, for him, he follows all the rules and regulations. There might be a few teachers who will break the rules, but he is one who will go with all the rules and regulations. So here he is, Taplow, imitating a very gentle, rather throaty voice. My dear Taplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve, no less and certainly no more. Do you know, sir, I think he may have marked me down rather than up for taking extra work. So I am here doing extra work on the last day, and even this might have created a negative impression on him. He is not going to give me marks for this, maybe. This is what he thinks. I mean, the man's hardly human. He doesn't have feelings, he doesn't have emotion. Sorry, sir, have I gone too far? So have I talked too much about my teacher? Well, yes, you have. Yes, much too far. Sorry, sir, I got carried away. That I was, you know, like talking about him and maybe enjoying that conversation, that I said too much than was required. You're talking too much, you're getting too involved. Evidently, he picks up a newspaper and opens it. Taplow, yes, sir. What was that Crocker Harris said to you? Just repeat it, would you? Imitating again, my dear Taplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve, no less and certainly no more. Frank looking severe, not in the least like him. Read your nice, Shylus, and be quiet. So here, first of all, the teacher asked him. He enjoyed when he was imitating the teacher, but then he realized his mistake. He's asked him to, you know, imitate the teacher again. And he says, no, this is not the way he speaks. This is not the way he talks. You've got it wrong. And you just concentrate on your classical literature, on your Greek literature. Silas. Look, what time did Mr. Crocker Harris tell you to be here? 6:30, sir. Well, he's 10 minutes late. Why don't you cut? You can go. You came here. You can say that I came and you weren't there. You could still play golf before lockup. Oh, no, I couldn't cut. Cut the croc, Mr. Crocker Harris. I shouldn't think it's ever been done in the whole time he's been here. No one has ran off. You know, no one has disobeyed him as long as Mr. Crocker Harris has been here. All the students, everybody very obedient. God knows what would happen if I did. He'd probably follow me home or something. I must admit, I envy him the effect he seems to have on you boys in the form. You all seem scared to death of him. What does he do? Beat you all or do something? So he says, see, he's not here. Even then, you're not ready to leave. You don't know what time he's going to come. You're going to sit and wait for him. You came here, you've done your work, you can leave. But he says, no, I will not go because naturally if he might follow me home and he'll, you know, like make me do this work again or give me more extra time and I want my result, I want my marks, he's worried about that. The teacher, Frank, he envies him. And of course, we have discussed about envying, about being jealous. Right? And envy would be, yeah, you want to be like someone. You wonder that why is it that he is so popular? Why the students are so scared of him? And what does he do? Right? Even I am a teacher. I also teach in the same way. I am like that. But what is it about that teacher? What makes him so, you know, like feared by the students? Okay. I must admit, I envy him the effect he seems to have on you boys in the form, in the class. You all seem scared to death of him. What does he do? Beat you all or something? Good Lord, no, he's not a sadist like one or two of the others. Who's a sadist? A sadist is a person who enjoys giving pain to others, who loves it when people are unhappy. Okay, let's give the child lots of homework. Let us make him work for extra hours. Oh yeah, you have an important function. I'll make sure you miss it. You know, that way, right? So he's not a sadist, no. he doesn't hurt us. He doesn't hurt us unnecessarily or cause us pain. But there are a few teachers who are like that. He is not like that at all. I beg your pardon. A sadist, sir, is someone who gets pleasure out of giving pain. Indeed. But I think you went on to say that some other masters. Well, of course, they are, sir. I won't mention names, but you know them as well as I do. Of course, I know most masters think we boys don't understand a thing. But sir, you're different. You're young, well, comparatively anyway, and your science, you must know what sadism is. What is sadistic behavior? When somebody enjoys giving pain, right, to others, making them uncomfortable, making them unhappy. He says, Mr. Crocker Harris might be a strict teacher, but he is not a sadist. And of course, he has called him that. See, this man is hardly human. He doesn't have any emotions. But he's not a sadist. There are other teachers who are like this. He says, you will understand. You're a young teacher. You teach science. You will know what being a sadist is. Good Lord, what are our schools coming to? How the students are talking to the teachers? What do they think about them? Anyway, the croc isn't a sadist. That's what I am seeing. He wouldn't be so frightening if he were, because at least it would show he had some feelings. Because right now, what did he say? Mr. Crocker Harris is hardly human. Or humans hain to feelings dikhayenge, emotions dikhayenge. But Mr. Crocker Harris is not like that. If he was a sadist, तब भी कुछ पता चलता ना कि कोई फीलिंग्स है. He likes to pain others, he likes to hurt others, but no, he doesn't do that at all. He is all shriveled up inside like a nut, and he seems to hate people to like him. It's funny that I don't know any other master who does not like being liked. So he says Mr. Crocker Harris does not that people like it, that people should like him. Okay, and he is all shriveled up. Shriveled up, kya hota hai? Dried up, sukha hua inside, you know, like a nut, like a walnut. When you open it, what's the nut like? It's all dried up inside, isn't it, right? And he seems to hate people to like him. But he does not want people to like him. He's happy in his own way. He does not people should like me. And this is very strange. And nowadays, it's very important to be liked, isn't it? We feel so good if we know that, yeah, somebody likes us. Now, students like me or teachers like you. So it makes us feel happy. It makes us feel good. But no, he does not show any kind of emotion. Na usko koi achha lagta hai, na koi bura lagta hai, na hi wo chahta hai ki mujhe koi like kare. You know, that way. He's that kind of a person. And I don't know any boy who doesn't use that for his own purpose. Well, it's natural, but not with a croc. So people use that, okay, their popularity, being liked, they use it. Mr. Crocker Harris. So he just was a little casual, but with a croc, no, you can't say nicknames and short names about the teacher. Mr. Crocker Harris. Mr. Crocker Harris, the funny thing is that in spite of everything, I do rather like him. I can't help it. And sometimes I think he sees it, and that seems to shrivel him up even more. Now, Taplow, he's talking about kitna strict teacher hai, kitna kaam diya hai, abhi tak aaye nahi hai, or he's complaining and all. But he says, in spite of all these qualities, I like that teacher. And if the teacher comes to know, he's going to become even more introvert. He's not going to show any feelings, which he already doesn't do that. Okay. I'm sure you're exaggerating. Exaggerated, bada chada ke. No, it's not like this. No, no, no. You're wrong. You say something wrong. No, sir, I am not. Now, please read this part. I think this is one of the best parts of the chapter. No, sir, I am not. In form is class. The other day, he made one of his classical jokes. That too related to literature. He made a joke. Of course, nobody laughed because nobody understood it. Class mein kisi ko samajh bhi nahi aaya, nobody laughed. myself included. So Tapla saying, even I didn't understand it. Still, I knew he had meant it as funny. So I laughed. Mujhe laga teacher ne joke crack kiya, koi nahi hasra, let me laugh. So I laughed. Out of ordinary common politeness. So I was being good, I was being a nice student, and I just laughed. And feeling a bit sorry for him for having made a poor joke. You know, sometimes you crack a joke and you're not able to create that kind of an impression. Nobody laughs at your joke. A joke is wasted, right? You don't get that response. Usko laga ki main zara, you know, let me be a good student, let me laugh. Now, I can't remember what the joke was, but suppose I make it. Now you laugh, sir. He says, mujhe kuch yaad nahi aa raha wo kya joke tha, but suppose hi maine joke sunaya tumhe. You laugh. Okay. Taplow, in a gentle, choti voice, is very good at imitating his teacher. Taplow, you laughed at my little joke. I noticed. I must confess that I am pleased at the advance your Latin has made, since you so readily have understood what the rest of the form did not. Perhaps now you would be good enough to explain it to them so that they too can share your pleasure. So what was the response of Mr. Crocker Harris? Right, when he cracked the joke, nobody laughed, only Taplow laughed. And the teacher came to know, isko bhi samajh mein nahi aa raha, aise he's just laughing, you know, just to make me happy. So what did he tell him? He said, Taplow, since you understood the joke, your Latin has progressed so much, so why don't you repeat it to the rest of the class? Right? So that they can also laugh. Poor Taplow. Ek to wo teacher ko khush karne ki koshish mein. What happened to him? He got caught in an unpleasant situation. Okay? Right? Is this clear? Have you understood or not? Have you understood? Up till here, is it clear? Yes? Why do you think Taplow is there discussing his teacher so much? In spite of being a very strict teacher, Taplow likes his teacher. Can it happen? Can it happen? Yes? Anyone? Can I have the answer, please? Okay.